He'll watch a movie, then he'll tell you all about it. It's the Armstrong Entertainment Show.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Armstrong Entertainment. This is Chad here, and I saw the movie Blade Runner 2049, directed by Denis Villeneuve, starring Ryan Gosling, Harrison Ford, Robin Wright, Jared Leto, and Wally. Okay, Wally's not in it. I just assumed he would be showing up at some point to clean up all the trash that's on this desolate planet. Let me just give you a little bit of a backstory on my knowledge of Blade Runner. I've never seen the film. I know, shocking. I love Harrison Ford. How have I never seen this film? I have seen bits and pieces throughout the years, kind of know what's going on, I kind of understand what it was about, but not really. And I realize that this movie came out almost 40 years ago, and all the fanboys who saw it on Thursday night are saying it's amazing, it's the best thing they've seen. They're just super excited because it's a sequel that's been they've been waiting for 37, 38 years, and they're just dying to see this film. So my knowledge going in was pretty minimal. I was very worried that I was not going to be able to keep up, and I was going to be confused and lost and struggling to keep up with the story. Quite the opposite happened. I was thinking of all of these plot twists and hidden meanings, and that is definitely something you have time to do because this movie is 2 hours and 45 minutes. Now let me just talk about the amazing things in this film. The visual effects. It's one of those movies you have to see in the movie theater. You cannot just rent this film and get the same experience. It's definitely one of those films you have to see in the theater, on the big screen, and see all the craziness that's happening. There are so many holograms, there are so many special effects, so many cool visual things to be looking at. You're like looking here and there. There's so much to look at, and it's beautiful, and beautiful. And it's shot, the musical score is also very, I was so anxious in this film with the score and the sound, and I was like, oh my gosh, please stop. It was scary, and it had me on the edge of my seat, and I was very nervous and anxious. I will say, though, it also was super annoying, because I felt like it was, like, cranked up a little too loud. It was at, like, a 10. Like, it was on, like, a max 10, and it should have been, like, at an 8. It was just too loud, and it was kind of annoying. Now, let me get into the story of the film. Ryan Gosling plays a police officer who is looking for a baby who was born from a robot. That's the plot. There's nothing else. There's lots of special effects, lots of amazing scenes, but there's so much visual fluff in this film. I literally was like, they could have taken out that scene. They could have taken out that scene. Oh, they could definitely take out all of these scenes. But those are the scenes that were the most memorable to me. There's like a Frank Sinatra jukebox scene that I was like, oh, it's so cool. There is an Elvis concert scene. I was like, oh, don't need it. But it was so cool, and that's what I'm going to remember. There was this weird three-way scene that was probably the highlight. So awesome, but really not very necessary. Even Jared Leto's character, his entire character could have been summed up, I feel like, in one scene. And instead they had him in a few different scenes. So in conclusion, there is so much visual fluff in scenes that are not needed in this 2 hour and 45 minute long movie. The plot is minimal at most. I literally was looking for something that would be a little bit more intellectually stimulating, and it wasn't quite there. But visually, this movie was superb. You have to see this in the theater. If you don't see this in the theater, don't even bother seeing it. The performances in this film were great. Ryan Gosling was perfect for this role. Harrison Ford was great. Jesse J? Who knew Jesse J was such a badass? And I love a strong female villain who's an actual good actress. Jesse J. Okay, it really wasn't Jesse J. And if you have no idea who Jesse J is, move along. This is definitely one of those films that I am never going to see again in my entire life, but I am so happy I did see it. If you don't see it in the theater, don't see it. Please see it in the theater. There is no reason not to. Just sit back and relax for your 2 hour and 45 minute movie viewing experience. I don't think I've ever seen a movie over 2 hours and 20 minutes that I've really enjoyed. So I just think it's so pretentious, and it costs $185 million. Good luck making that money back. They probably will. But it's called Blade Runner 2049. It probably will make that much money back. It's crazy. Go check it out. Only in the theater. Until next time.
He'll watch a movie, then he'll tell you all about it. It's the Armstrong Entertainment Show.